I'm going to compare two plug-in hybrid vehicles that emerged into the market this year, kind of taking over the Chevy Volt dynasty, and they are Toyota RAV4 and Ford Escape. So let's get going. Welcome to E4 Electric, your number one source of electric car scoop. If this is your first time here and you are interested in everything that's going on in the world of electric cars, go ahead and click on that subscribe button and the bell notification icon so you don't miss anything moving forward. First, for those of you who don't know what a plug-in hybrid is, it's essentially a hybrid between the electric car and a gas car. So you will plug it in, you will charge the battery, it will go a certain distance just on your electric charge, and then once it runs out of electricity, a gas engine takes over and then it operates like a regular gas car. Now, until this year, the best plug-in hybrid on the market was considered to be the Chevy Volt. It had over 50 miles of electric range, it looked great, and was very affordable. I drive a Chevy Volt and absolutely love it. And I used to own a Tesla, so that should tell you something. Unfortunately, last year, Chevy has decided to discontinue the Volt and didn't really replace it with anything else. So that left a void in the marketplace for a good plug-in hybrid, because the plug-in hybrids that you will see right now that are for sale are not very good. They're mainly compliance cars, the electric technology there is relatively poor, and the electric range is very, very underwhelming, mainly under 20 miles. That's why I'm so excited to talk about these two plug-in hybrids, and let's face it, they're gonna sell very well because most people are still not ready for a fully electric car in their lives. They're just not ready to ditch an engine. They're not ready to ditch the gas stations. I can only assume because they still love just the right mixture of the slight nausea and the lightheadedness from the fumes. That's why a plug-in hybrid is a perfect gateway drug into the future electric car ownership. Think of it as an electric car with training wheels. You will probably still be able to cover most of your average daily commute with the electric charge, but just in case, you will have the gas engine that you're so familiar with to take over at any time, so you will never have the range anxiety. All right, so we are ready to dive in and compare the RAV4 and the Escape, both plug-in hybrids, both going on the market this year. Before that, a quick reminder that this video and this channel is sponsored by Evonex, the Tesla community's accessory store. Use E4Electric, the name of this channel, as a discount code for all of your purchases over $100. First, let me quickly mention that some of these numbers are still being worked on by Toyota and Ford, so they can slightly change by the end of this year. Now, the dimensions of this car are so almost exactly the same that there is no advantage of one over the other, so I'm gonna skip that and move on directly to power. Almost right away, you will see big difference in this category already, giving the advantage to RAV4. Now, RAV4 will come with much more combined horsepower of 302 to the Escape's 209. Now, another big difference is that RAV4 will come as an all-wheel drive vehicle, where the Escape will only come as a front-wheel drive. So if that matters to you, RAV4 is your guy. Now let's talk about arguably the most important thing in a plug-in hybrid, which is the electric range. Now the RAV4's battery is going to have a size of 17.8 kilowatt hours to the Escape size of 14.4 kilowatt hours. Now even though RAV4's battery is about 25% bigger than the Escape's, it doesn't really translate into the electric range advantage because the RAV4 will have about 39 miles of EPA range, where the Escape will have 37 miles of the EPA range. So as you can see, the difference is only a couple of miles. Now, really quickly, let's talk about the cargo space, and that's where there is not much of a difference either. The cargo space for a RAV4 is about 37.6 cubic feet, and the Escape will have a little bit less at 34.4 cubic feet. Now, this is with the seats up. If you put the seats down, then it shouldn't make that much of a difference because just like I said, the size of both vehicles is pretty much the same. All right, now we came to the most important thing about any car, at least for most people, and that's the price tag. The RAV4 will start at $38,100. That excludes the destination fee. And the Escape will start at about $33,040. That also excludes the destination fee. All right, now because it's an electric car, we still have some math to do, unfortunately, but that's okay. I am Russian. I can do it all in my head because we still need to subtract the federal tax credit here in the United States. Now, for RAV4, it will get the full tax credit of $7,500, but because of the battery side, the Escape will get a little bit less, which will be $6,800. All right, so now if I do a little bit of math in my Russian... Back to the B-roll. Much better now. Okay, so what I came up with is $30,600 for the total price for RAV4 and $26,240 for the Escape. Now, this excludes any local incentives for an electric car, which you should look up specifically for your state. So as you can see, the price difference is almost $5,000, so that gives advantage to the Escape. Let's also quickly mention that there will be no DC fast charging feature in this plug-in hybrids, and it was never expected, but both cars will be easily charged overnight at the level 2 240 volt charging in about 10 to 12 hours using your regular 110 outlets, which still should be pretty much perfect from the time you park your car in the garage to the next morning when you will need to use it again. All right, so which one is the winner? Well, as always, it depends what it is that you're looking for. So let's look at it from three different angles. Well, first, if you're looking to give your money to a company that has put more effort into the electrification of their fleet, well, that will definitely be Ford, because first of all, this year they're coming out with a great all-electric Mustang Mach-E that really has a reservation list of at least 1 year, and it will be a huge success. It has also invested into another all-electric car company called Rivian, and they're making an all-electric truck. They have already produced a couple of, you know, not such great, but still all-electric cars, where Toyota hasn't done much at all. As a matter of fact, Toyota has contributed a lot to slowing down the electrification, trying to really get away with just hybrids, or trying to promote the, what I consider to be dead at arrival hydrogen fuel cell technology. So if you want to give your money to the company that has contributed the most to the progress of electrification of our vehicles, well, that will be Ford. Now, the second category is power and all-wheel drive. Now, RAV4 has a huge advantage in both. It has way more horsepower, and it's the only one of the two that does have the all-wheel drive option. So, if that's important to you, then you should go with RAV4. And the third one is probably something that's going to be a big deciding factor no matter what, which is the price. And that's where the Escape has the advantage, almost $5,000 cheaper, and it's pretty much the same price after the incentives as its gas-powered version. All right, you got some thinking to do. Please do let me know which one you decide on and why. Put that in the comment section for this video. I'm looking forward to all of your comments. Other than that, see you guys next time. And remember, oh, sorry, to stay charged.